This tutorial has been made possible thanks to your monthly support on Patreon. Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with another Photoshop tutorial, and today we're going to be taking a look at video composition. Yep, video in Photoshop is possible, and as a Photoshop CS6, it's that much easier. So today we're going to be taking multiple video clips, and we're going to be compositing them on top of each other to make an okay video look fantastic. Let's take a look. All right, so here in front of me, I have three video clips that we're going to be using in this video to make the original video look a little bit better. This video here, if I press the space bar to play it, we have this guy running slow motion, and it looks okay, but there's not much going on. There's not much cinematic effect to this video. We want to make it look that much better. And we're going to do so using these two video clips, dancing sunbeams to kind of give it a nice looking effect, and we're going to be adding some rain as well. Now these video clips I grabbed from videoblocks.com, which allows you to download unlimited videos for 7 days, and if you click the link in the description, you get a huge discount on a yearly membership, which is pretty snazzy. So let's go ahead and begin. I'm going to grab this video right here. I'm gonna drag it right into Photoshop, and it's gonna load that video in. Command or Control 0 so I can see the whole video on my screen. And if I press my space bar, the video will play back, just like I saw it a minute ago. Now very quickly, to get rid of the black bars at the top and the bottom, I'm gonna press C to grab my crop tool, and simply drag, holding down my Alt or Option key from the top to constrain it just like that, and press Return or Enter. I don't want those black bars, and it's only gonna mess up the other video clips. So now that the first video is in, before we add any other video clips, I'm gonna make some very easy color corrections to this current video. I'm gonna scrub back to the beginning, I'm gonna go down to the bottom to my adjustment layers, and let's say I'm gonna add an exposure adjustment layer. And let me correct the gamma just a little bit, pull that down, maybe bring the exposure down a little bit, just to darken it a touch, nothing too fancy, just to sharpen up that contrast a little bit, somewhere right around there. That's before and after. Nothing too fancy, but it may help a little bit with the next video clips. All right, perfect. So now before we add the next video clip, what we want to do is click on the video group at the top. So if we add it to the current video group, it's gonna add it at the end of this video. We don't want that. So now that the top video group is selected, let's switch back over to Finder, grab the next video clip, which is right here, Dancing Sunbeams, and drag it right into Photoshop on top of the current video. Now, it's not the exact same size, so I'm gonna simply hold down Option and Shift and drag it upwards a little bit and maybe drag it downward so I grab all the sunbeams at the top left corner. And when that's done, you can press Return or Enter to accept the changes. And you're gonna notice it placed it on top of the previous video clip, and that's because we selected video group 1 instead of putting it into the current video group. So now that the next video clip has been added, if we press the space bar, we're gonna see that video clip playing back a little bit slower because Photoshop is rendering it as it goes, but we can't see the video clip underneath it. So what do we do? Well, there are a few ways to deal with this, but the simplest way is to adjust the blending mode. And all we have to do over here to the right in the layers panel, instead of normal, we're gonna scroll down and set it to screen. And just like that, the dark tones in that video clip are now invisible, or mostly invisible, allowing us to see through to the previous video clip. And if you want to, you can change the opacity, decrease a little bit so it's not too strong, somewhere, let's say, around 85%. And now if we press the space bar, we can now see the sunbeams and the guy running in the background. Again, as I mentioned, it's a little bit slower than it usually is because Photoshop is rendering it as the video is playing. And you can see the rendered part is with the blue line right at the top of the timeline. If I scrub back to the beginning and play it back, it's a lot smoother than it was before. So that's starting to look a little bit better. I'm gonna scrub back to the beginning of the timeline and we're gonna add another video clip. This time I'm gonna add rain to our video, plop that right in there, and just like before, hold down Alt or Option, Shift and drag upwards so it fills the whole video. Press Return or Enter, and if I press the space bar, you're gonna see that we now have rain, but we can't see through. So just like we did in the last video, go over to my blend modes on the right, and change the blend mode to screen. And all of a sudden, if I press the space bar again, we now see rain. Now this rain's a little bit too intense, so I'm gonna decrease the opacity a little bit more than the last clip, somewhere around 60%. We want a little bit of subtle rain, and that looks pretty good right there.
Now, of course, at this point, as you add more video clips and as you change the blending modes, you may have to go back and change the color as well. So to do that, I'm going to click on the Dancing Sunbeams video, go down to my adjustment layers at the bottom, and let's start with hue and saturation. For this one, I'm just going to simply adjust the hue a little bit to make it a little bit more yellow so it's not so orange, just like that, right around there. And now I'm going to go to the top of my layers panel, add a curves adjustment layer to sharpen things up just a little bit, just like that. And finally, to finish it off, I'm going to add one of my favorite adjustment layers, a gradient map, but I'm going to make sure to add the photographic toning preset. So I'm going to open up the gradient picker, click on the gear icon, and make sure my photographic toning presets are added. I can click append just to add them to my current list, but I already do have them right here. And if I go ahead and start selecting any of them, you're going to notice things are looking a little bit strange. We probably don't want our video looking like that. If I play it back, it really doesn't look that great. So instead of just keeping it the way it is, I'm going to set the blend mode at either overlay or soft light. Both of them will give you different effects. And once you have one of them selected, you can simply click on one and scroll through with your right arrow key to find the gradient that you like the best. I'm going to stick with this one right here, press return or enter. And to see how it looks with other blending modes, you can simply change it. Let's say soft light or overlay. I think overlay is looking a little bit better. I'm going to scrub back to the beginning. Press the spacebar, and we now have our completed video. Again, it will be slow the first time around because Photoshop is rendering each and every frame. It's applying those adjustment layers. It's applying those blending modes to your video in real time. That's why it's looking a little bit slower than it did previously. But once that portion is rendered, I'm going to scrub back to the beginning, press the spacebar again, and you'll now see the video in real time, which looks amazing. Just to remind you, this is what we started with. This video right here, which is boring, the colors are wrong, nothing really looks great about this video. We added some sunbeams, then we added some rain, and we now have the final video that you're seeing playing on your screen right now, all done in Photoshop with a few video clips, adjustment layers, and blending modes.
And there you have it, video editing in Photoshop. It's definitely possible, and you can do a lot of powerful things with it, and I'm going to be covering even more things you can do with video editing in Photoshop in the very near future. But if you guys want to make this possible, if you guys want to help me release my content on a more consistent basis, there are two things you can do. Patreon.com/HowardPinsky. You can submit a monthly pledge, a monthly contribution, whatever you want to call it. It could be $1, $10, $8 million. That'd be awesome. But if you do want to help my content, you can go there, or you can go to iceflowstudios.com and you can purchase for $10 or more all of my tutorials from 2012 and 2013. That's 120 HD tutorials that you can purchase to watch offline, do what you want with them, but don't sell them because I will come after you. But those are available for $10. 120 tutorials for $10. You can't beat that. And at least I hope not. If you can, send me a link to where someone's beating that, and I'll maybe match it. So that's that. Photo composition, no. Video composition, in whatever this tutorial was, that's what you just watched. I'll see you guys in the next video.